Welcome to Young Business Professionals. I'm Felix and I hope you're all fine. Today I'm presenting to you the fourth video of our APQP series. In a few minutes I will explain to you the most important facts to be considered in APQP Phase 3, the process development phase. If you are interested in increasing your automotive knowledge, please feel free to subscribe to my channel and like the video. You may also check out our Facebook page, through which we would like to create a community that shall support each other, growing everybody's knowledge. What is the scope of the process development phase? In this part of the project, the future production process for the product is being developed. In addition, this planned equipment is being procured and approved. This phase is starting already in parallel to the product development phase and may start theoretically from that moment at which the product design can be foreseen roughly. It makes sense to think about how to assemble the product already at that time. It is useful to start as early as possible in parallel to the product development phase and to cooperate as close as possible with the engineering department. The procurement kickoff is as well part of that process. In parallel, product validation tests are being performed as well. That's the reason for the overlapping of the process development phase and phase for product and process validation. Now, let's take a more detailed look on all single working packages of APQP Phase 3. The following working packages are part of the process design phase: process flow and layout, process FMEA, double check of plant resources, control plan and MSA plan, kickoff of production equipment and definition of suppliers, product and process trainings to be planned, logistic concept definition, pre-serial production, and the quality gate phase 3. Process flow and layout. It is useful to know as soon as possible if the process that shall be installed into the production plant later on can be installed in there without any constraint from dimensional point of view, and if the flow of the material is reasonable. A process flow plan helps to design the process and shows how the process, starting from receipt of incoming materials until shipment of the finished goods from the production plant, is running. This is also an important input for the process FMEA and control plan. It is a simple tool that helps outside people to understand the flow of the process. PFMEA, or Process Failure Mode and Effects Analysis. As explained already in the previous video, we will just roughly touch this topic in here, as the focus shall be on the full phase and not on explaining this important activity in detail. The purpose of the FMEA is to identify weak points in the process design. Based on the process design measures that shall increase the security to fulfill product requirements reliably. The PFMEA is using inputs from the design FMEA and is identifying potential weak points in the production process. In addition, it's providing important outputs that will be used in the control plan. A few more important facts are that the FMEA should be started as early as possible in the project, from the very first sketch if possible. It is never closed except the product is going end of life, and the PFMEA serves a lot of input for the control plan. Double check of plant resources. Before to kick off procurement of the plant equipment, it makes sense to double check the originally planned resources. The project has moved forward and eventually things have developed into a different direction than planned originally. Often additional or change requirements cause design changes that are impacting potentially the process and its cycle times as well. This may also result in changed costs, layouts, and capacity. Due to that, it makes sense to check the following things: the status of the budget, the status of the calculation, a number of operators that is required for the assembly process, required space in the production plan, and also the achievability of production capacities which have been promised in the quotation to the customer originally. Call plan and measurement system analysis plan. The next working package we are going to take a look onto is the control plan creation and MSA plan. A control plan is making sure that the production process for the product is running in a structured way. The target of this tool is to prevent failures and to make sure that product requirements will be kept. The control plan is receiving its inputs from the process flowchart, the drawing, the process FMEA, but as well from experience of customers or the internal team. Planning of required test equipments and MSA planning is about to define which test equipments are required to check defined characteristics of the product. Therefore, it might be useful to create a plan what equipment to be procured. In addition, the MSA for these equipments needs to be planned. The target of the MSA is to analyze if planned equipments are capable to identify the defined measurement value. Kickoff of production equipment and supplier definition. After the planning process of all production equipment, including preliminary discussions with suppliers, are closed, quotations of suppliers are being negotiated. After that, it may make sense to choose the best supplier through a committee, a group of responsibles in the company, to define the suppliers for tools, production equipment, gouges, and board components as well. All requirements should have been exchanged and clarified with sub-suppliers based on a specification sheet as detailed as possible. After making the final decision, orders are being sent to the suppliers. They are starting now their own APQP process and are sampling the subcomponent in case you have nominated a board component to the customer. Assembly lines or tools will be approved by the process designer of your company once they are ready. It is of special importance that all requirements are defined as detailed as possible at this time. Things that should be ready and clear are drawings for single parts, including special characteristics, specification sheets, PPAP requirements for the sub-suppliers, and of course also the timing expectation. Product and process training plan. Over the period of time in which all suppliers are working to produce the production equipment, you get time to define which trainings are required for the team in a production plant that shall be responsible to run the production line in the future. It is important that all employees that will be responsible in future are being trained as detailed as possible. In order to make sure that no essential part of the training is missing, it makes sense to create a training plan. Who needs to be trained, when, and by whom? Important trainings might be the following: training of operators with regard to assembly procedures. The plant quality team needs to be trained with regard to core requirements and functions of products and special characteristics, as well as the production manager. Logistic concept and definition. Due to the fact that during the time at which the production equipment is in preparation, it is required to supply pre-seal demands of specific part levels to the customer, it is recommended and often mandatory to create a packaging concept. This should be agreed in between logistic department of supplier and customer. In some cases, the packaging concept of the pre-seal production is differing from the one for serial production, as for instance volumes are lower and sometimes empty goods management are not yet available. It makes sense to perform packaging trials as early as possible, as Complex products might be damaged during transport or similar. Pre-serial production. The start of the pre-serial production is an important milestone in phase 3 of the project. Ideally, production equipment should be in the final plant already. Often, the equipment is not yet finally approved, as small details need to be changed and adjusted. First parts will be produced, checked, and supplied. Typically, quantities are not yet that high in order to slowly ramp up the production. These parts are also used for production validation tests often. That will be performed in phase 4 of the project. It is recommended and often the case that the project team gives a big support in this part of the phase, although some points might be managed already by the future production team. Quality gate phase 3. Once all these activities are done, the project manager has once more the pleasure to present the progress of that process phase to the management and top management of the company. That may then decide, based on a recommendation of the project manager, to release APQP phase 3 and to move on with phase 4. During such a gate review, the project manager is presenting which activities have been performed and if they have been closed in time. In case there are still actions unfulfilled, this is the right time and place for the manager to escalate to the top management and to ask for special attention and support of the management team for specific working packages. In such a case, the management team may, of course, also decide to not release the phase. Anyhow, in case they release the phase, the team is proceeding with activities of the next one. What are important learnings of phase 3? I listed the following points. Please try to provide as much as possible time to your suppliers to give them the chance to do a proper job with producing the equipment. A result of high quality requires time and resources, and make sure you define the requirements for them as best as possible and in time. In case orders are placed and requirements for suppliers are clear and they are capable, a more relaxing phase of the project starts now until the equipment is getting ready. At the end of phase 3 and the transition to phase 4, high attention is required, as often a lot of final changes have to be implemented under big time pressure. The better the team was working in phase 1 and 2, the smoother this phase should be running now. Well, this was my short introduction into the process design phase. Thanks to all of you for watching this video until the end. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm looking forward for your likes and your feedback below the video. Please subscribe to the channel to not miss further APQP videos. Please feel free to join our Facebook community. You will find the link below the video. Have a great day.